Hi, everyone. I feel very fortunate to have grown up in the 60s where everything was peace and love, gas was 25 cents a gallon, and rock music was changing with every new band that came out. There were all these fantastic drummers coming up at that time, but one in particular, Mitch Mitchell from the Jimi Hendrix Experience, was a major drum hero of mine, and this tribute was a labor of love to do, so I can't wait to share it with you guys. Also, please take a second to like this video, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I sure would appreciate it, and thank you. So, here we go.
And you know you're a sweet little lovely. I wanna take you home. Why would do you go home? You've got to be our man. Oh, man.
John Graham Mitch Mitchell, born in Ealing, Middlesex, England, in 1946 or 47, depending on which internet site you read, Mitch started out as a child actor in movies and TV before taking up the drums.
You look very pleased with yourself, Wendover.
Yes, sir.
The gay abandon of a clear conscience?
Exactly, sir. You can't whack it.
I can whack anything.
While he was still in school, he worked at the Marshall Drum Shop in Hanwell, Northwest London, and he took lessons from the owner, Jim Marshall. Mitchell's early influences were all the giants of the jazz world, Elvin Jones, Max Roach, Joe Morello. He got his playing and recording experience in several bands like Pete Nelson and the Travelers, the Riot Squad, both popular bands at the time. For 10 months between 1965 and 66, he worked with Georgie Fame and the Blue Flames. Now, Georgie Fame would eventually fire his whole band, and this turned out to be Mitch's big break, because now he needed a gig. Now, literally the next day, Chaz Chandler, the bass player for the Animals, then managing a young Jimi Hendrix, asked him to audition for Jimmy's new band. He beat out everybody but one guy, Ansley Dunbar. So Chandler and Hendrix tossed a coin, and Mitchell got the gig. Jimi Hendrix now had his new band with Mitch Mitchell and Noel Redding on bass called the Jimi Hendrix Experience. Here's a clip of Mitch telling how quickly they were thrown together as a band and how they dealt with it.
I was recorded like about 3 weeks after we got together. Mm-hmm. You know, like we were just thrown together. You know, we weren't friends, we'd never met or anything. Uh-huh. It's one of those things, three guys being thrown together and sort of, there you are, you're a group now, and see what you can sort out, you know.
Hendrix gave Mitchell a lot of freedom to play, and that's everything to a drummer, and in my opinion, he became more than just a sideman. He was a big part of that overall Hendrix sound. And in the span of just a few short years, Mitch Mitchell really rewrote the rules of what a rock drummer could do. On the first album, Are You Experienced, there were these hard-hitting psychedelic songs. I love The Power of Purple Haze, and I still love playing it after all these years. Man, Mitch taught me a six-stroke roll from the opening of Manic Depression and how to play 3/4 time. Then there was his instrumental, Third Stone from the Sun. Now this song totally blew my mind. It was jazz, it was funk, it was rock all in one, and I learned what a jazz ride pattern was. I was so overwhelmed by Mitch's playing on the first album that in December 1967, I'm standing outside the front of my local Tower Records in Sacramento, California, where all my money went, by the way, waiting for the doors to open so I could buy the new Hendrix album they'd been advertising, Axis Bold as Love. It opens with a radio interview, and then they segue into the first song, Up from the Skies, and Mitch Mitchell is using brushes.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to radio station EXP. Tonight we are featuring an interview with a very peculiar-looking gentleman who goes by the name of Mr. Paul Caruso on the dodgy subject of are there or are there not flying saucers, or UFOs. Please, Mr. Caruso, could you give us your regarded opinion on this nonsense about spaceships and even space people?
Thank you. As you all know, you just can't believe everything you see and hear, can you? Now, if you will excuse me, I must be on my way.
I just wanna talk to you. I wanna do you no harm. I just wanna know about your different lives. Of this kind of people fun. I heard some you got your families living in cages, tall and cold. Some just stay the end.
Then it got heavy with Spanish Castle Magic. And then, the song with my favorite intro fill of all time, Little Wing.
Well, she's walking through the clouds.
In 1968, the Electric Ladyland double album came out. Hendrix had done a lot of experimenting in the studio, and it was showing up in the form of extended jams. I personally think Mitch Mitchell's play on the third album is his finest work. Listen to some of the soloing in 1983, about 8 minutes in, and his playing in the breakdown of the long blues jam, Voodoo Chili, still gives me chills to this day. Hendrix's cover of Bob Dylan's All Along the Watchtower is one of my favorites. Watchtower's in 4/4, but it doesn't start on the one. Drums enter on and of three, and the count is very tricky to hear before the beat is established.
There must be some kind of way.
I was extremely fortunate to see Jimi Hendrix twice, growing up in Sacramento, mainly because I'm old. The first time, September 15th, 1968, Jimi played like a wild man, with his teeth and setting his guitar on fire, and Mitch was just unbelievable backing him up. The second time, April 26, 1970, outside at a state fair a few months before he died, and I actually have pictures, crazy, which you can find on the internet. After Hendrix's death, there's not a lot out there on what Mitch Mitchell did outside of Hendrix. He was involved in many Hendrix projects with engineer Eddie Kramer, Cry of Love, Rainbow Bridge, and many others. In December 1968, he was in a short-lived band called Dirty Mac Band with John Lennon, Eric Clapton, and Keith Richards. They played one show on the Rolling Stones' Rock and Roll TV special.
Eagle picks my eye, the worm, he licks my bone. Feels so suicidal, just like Dylan's Mr. Jones. I'm lonely.
In 1970, he toured with Jack Bruce and Friends on his Songs for a Tailor album. Unfortunately, there's only pictures of that great band, no recordings that are worth hearing. He was in a band called Ramatam in 1972 with Mike Panera and April Lawton, but he left after the first album when it wasn't successful. He basically lived semi-retired in Europe for the rest of the 70s to the 90s, occasionally doing a recording session or performing. And I moved on to other drummers and kind of forgot Mitch Mitchell for a while. One day, 2008, I'm driving down the freeway and the radio said Mitch Mitchell had died. He had spent his final days playing on the Experience Hendrix tour, which ended in Portland, Oregon. And 5 days later, he died in his sleep of natural causes in a hotel room in Portland. I had to pull over to the side of the road. It was just heartbreaking. Mitch was my compass as a drummer growing up. I just loved his playing. So I'm going to go out playing a song from the first album that is rocking, funky, and to be honest, really, really tough as hell to play after all these years. I mean, I think I did like 8 takes just trying to make it sound halfway close to what Mitch is capable of. So thanks everyone for watching, and remember, practice hard and keep it simple. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. And if you're new to my channel, ring the bell. Give it a thumbs up and comment. That's very important to me. I love to hear your feedback. Follow me on Instagram at Guy Gelso, and also don't forget to check out GuyGelso.com. There you can enter your email for any new events and shows I'm doing. Thanks for watching. Practice hard and keep it simple.